Good morning, students. Welcome back. In our previous video, we have discussed about meaning of psychology and its history. Today, I am going to start chapter 1 of psychology. Its name is What is Psychology? As I told you earlier, the word psychology is derived from two Greek words, psyche and logos. Psyche means mind or soul and logos means study. It's therefore the study of mind or soul. Here is modern definition of psychology. Psychology is a defined science that study mental processes, behavior and experiences. Let's broken this definition. First, mental process. We use our mental process when we think and try to solve a problem, to know or remember something. One level at which these mental processes are reflected is the brain activity. As we think or solve a mathematical problem, our brain activities can be observed using different techniques of brain imaging. We cannot see that brain activities and mental processes are the same, although they are interdependent. Here is one question. Mind and brain, are they same? No, they are not same, because the brain has a physical structure but mind has no physical structure. Unlike the brain, the mind does not have a physical structure or has a location. Even when we are asleep, some mental activities go on. We dream and receive some information such as knock on the door while we are asleep. Some psychologists have shown that we also learn and remember in our sleep. Mental processes such as remembering, learning, knowing, perceiving, feeling are of interest to psychologists. They study these processes to try to understand how the mind works. So next is your behavior. What is behavior? It refers to anything we do, think and feel. Behaviors are responses or reactions we make or activities we engage in. When something is hurled at you, or your eyes blink in a simple reflex action. You are taking an examination and can feel your heart pounding. Next, you decide to go for a particular movie with a friend. So behaviors may be simple or complex. Here is types of behavior. First is covert, second is overt. Covert behavior that cannot be observed by anyone. Behavior pattern known only to the person experiencing it. Examples like fear, jealousy. These are some two examples of covert behavior because it cannot be observed. We can observe these activities with techniques. Overt behavior can be observed by anyone. Behavioral pattern which can be observed by others. Examples like tears, smile, we can observe these activities. Next is experience. Experiences are subjective in nature. We cannot directly observe or know someone else's experience. Only the experiencing person can be aware or be conscious of his or her experiences. Here is example. When a yogi meditates to enter a different level of consciousness and creates a new kind of experience, so he can only experience, we cannot. Other example, when a drug addict takes a particular kind of drug to get a high, even though such drugs are extremely harmful, but he can only experience that feeling, we cannot. So, experiences are influenced by internal and external conditions of the experiencer. So, this is the definition of psychology. Here is psychology as a discipline. In this two terms, psychology as a natural science, psychology as a social science, psychology as a discipline. Here, discipline is a study and knowledge. So, next time we will discuss this topic, psychology as a discipline. In this, psychology as a natural science and psychology as a social science. Thank you.